over a decade now, Ford has pretty much had the off-road trophy truck market to itself with the F-150 Raptor. But Ram is not in the business of letting other companies hog the spotlight. That's why they've taken one of Dodge's supercharged Hellcat motors and stuck it into one of their trucks. This is the 2021 Ram 1500 TRX. They nicknamed it the T-Rex because this car has only one goal in mind: kill the Raptor. So let's start with an exterior walk around and find out what makes the T-Rex a T-Rex. Well, for starters, we've got sort of a Ram Rebel front end with the big Ram written across here. Because we have this big supercharged V8 under the hood, you've got to cool that properly. So 50% of your air is going to come in through the grill. Another 50% of all of the air comes in through this functional scoop. That's a great way to keep such a big motor cool. Now, this is 2 inches taller than a standard Ram 1500, giving you 11.8 inches of ground clearance and 32 inches of water force. That's all great capability. And as you can see, we've got these really wide fenders here. This is actually 8 inches wider than a standard Ram. So wide, in fact, that you have to put marker lights on it to show the width. And it's really cool how they've integrated that right here on the hood scoop. Moving around the side, we again see these massive fender flares that house our massive 35-inch tires. This sits on 2.6-inch Bilstein Blackhawk shocks, which are specific to the TRX. They are active damper valves as well. We've got independent suspension up front with a massive Dana 60 solid rear axle. That is tough stuff. We do have a locking rear axle back here. All-wheel drive, you can't put this truck into rear-wheel drive mode. You do have a four-wheel high, four-wheel low, and the rear axle locking function if you are going to do some slow speed off-roading or rock crawling. Moving around the back, you'll notice that we have a 6.5-foot bed. It's the only way to get one of these Ram TRXs. We have some specific details, 4x4 TRX written on the other side with the big Ram. You'll notice that these exhaust pipes are massive, specific to the TRX. We also have our tow hooks right here. We have some tow hooks up front as well. And you'll notice that this bed is really high. It's a little bit difficult to get stuff out of it because this truck is so tall. You can get this optional bed step. You just kind of kick it out like so, and you can stand on it to grab stuff easily out of the bed. And it retracts really easily. You just kind of kick it up. I think that's a useful feature. Now, before we get it out on the road, the big story here is under the hood, because while the F-150 Raptor makes do with a twin turbo V6 with about 450 horsepower, the T-Rex gets a 6.2 liter supercharged Hemi motor with 702 horsepower and 650 pound-feet of torque. FCA, please never change. This is a hilarious output. I love how quick this truck is. It goes 0 to 60, they say in about 4.5 seconds, but some independent tests have got it at about 4 seconds. It'll do about 113 miles an hour top speed. And my favorite part about this engine is if you lift up this engine cover, you get a little secret icon, which is a T-Rex eating a Raptor. You could definitely tell the messaging with this model. All right, so now let's focus on what makes the T-Rex unique on the interior. This is not going to be a deep dive on the Ram 1500. If you want to know more about this truck and the rear cargo space and all of that, we have another video on the Ram 1500 Limited with the diesel on our channel. We're just going to focus on the TRX bits. So for starters, you get a different steering wheel than you're going to get on any other Ram. It's a flat bottom. We've got these big paddle shifters that are the biggest I've ever seen on an FCA product to date. Now, it looks like they're big and they extend all the way up and down, but if you actually look behind it, there's an upper piece and a lower piece that you can pull and they're both connected. That's because FCA still has volume and radio controls on the other side, which is kind of interesting. The gauges are definitely sportier on this TRX model. They look kind of like the ones you'll get in a Rebel. They have red accenting and a big TRX logo right there in the gauge cluster. That looks really cool. We've got our red starter button, the same that you would get in a Hellcat. Now, you get cloth seats with a little bit of vinyl base on this truck for just under $70,000, but we have a very expensive option package here. There's a couple of different option packages you can get. So we've got the nicer leather with the suede. These seats are heated and ventilated. They're heated and ventilated in the rear as well, which is really unique at any price level. I love that Ram continues to do that. Here in the center console, it's mostly the same that you get in a regular Ram. We've got our multiple USB ports, a wireless charger, cup holders, but instead of having the rotating knob shifter here on the dash. We do have a traditional shifter. Feels a little bit sportier here on the T-Rex. And if I put it in reverse, we still do have our amazing camera systems that you can look all over the place. That really helps for off-roading. Now, in place of where our shifter would have been, we have some very unique controls. Right here, we have our four-wheel drive controls, auto, high, four-wheel drive, low, our rear axle lock, and then this is our launch control button. We're gonna play around with that later. You can see it actually looks like a drag strip light, which is really neat. We've got our mode select. You can either go left or right on the mode select, or if you want to see all of the modes at once, you can push the big red T-Rex button, which pulls up this screen. So we've got four on-road settings, four off-road settings. So our on-road settings are sport, tow, snow, auto. As you can see, they change up our transmission behavior, stability control, suspension, steering. The suspension, as I said, is adaptive, and it can really go from like firm to very nice and soft here off-road. Our off-road modes are custom, mud and sand, rock, and then Baja, which is for high-speed off-road. That's my favorite of all the different drive modes. We also have a lot of the same stuff that you're going to get on a Hellcat model here. We've got our drag timers, gauges, G-force, engine, dyno, vehicle dynamics, all of this stuff with some special off-road stuff as well with our transfer case, our wheel articulation, whatever. I love that FCA puts all of this stuff on the screen. Our massive 12-inch screen, by the way, which is one of the best in the business. Big maps, big, we've got Android Auto and Apple CarPlay compatibility. It is a really great system. But I love the fact that none of the TRX stuff takes away from the overall comfort here. We have double thick windows, so it is very quiet in here on the road. We've got a 19-speaker optional Harman Kardon audio system that sounds fantastic. The rear seats are still absolutely enormous. They slide and recline really well. You can lift them up to get more storage. And as I mentioned, they're heated and ventilated, which you don't even get on a $100,000 BMW X7. So in terms of technology, luxury, and comfort in here, you don't lose anything with the T-Rex. All right, so now it's time to get the TRX off-road, because that's what it was built for, and we're gonna do an off-road launch control. So you just push the launch button, it's gonna tell you to apply brake pressure and then apply throttle, and watch what's about to happen. We go off traction, there we go. This thing sounds immense. It makes such a good noise. The suspension is so good. We just go over bumps like they are nothing. That was 0 to 60 in about 5 or 6 seconds off-road. You can do it in about 4 seconds on the road. You'll be at doing 100 miles an hour in 10 and a half seconds in this car. And if you wanted to bring it to the drag strip, you could do the quarter mile in 12.9 seconds at 109 miles an hour. This thing tops out. It says at about 118. I have personally got it up to about 116 on this off-road area, and it'll hit that no problems whatsoever. So in terms of performance, there's really no pickup truck on the market that's gonna beat this. And the only penalty that you're really paying for is obviously the size. It's enormous, it's very hard to park and things like that. And the fuel economy. The fuel economy is not great. You're gonna get 10 in the city, 14 on the highway, and 12 combined. We've been averaging about 9 miles per gallon driving around here. But yeah, this drivetrain is absolutely fantastic. We've got our Torque Flight 8-speed automatic transmission, same as you get in like a Hellcat. Obviously, it's beefed up here. I do actually like taking advantage of the paddle shifters here. They're not the quickest in the world, but they are bigger here, as I showed you on the T-Rex. Gives you just that little bit more of a fun experience. So now I'm gonna pull off from the main road into something a lot more bumpy, a lot more rutty, because we wanna test out that 13 inches of suspension travel here over this. Oh my goodness. So we just did this in the Ford Bronco Sport, which is a much smaller vehicle. Now I'm definitely feeling these bumps, maybe a little bit more than I did in the Jeep Gladiator, but we just have so much ground clearance and so much suspension travel. I'm in the Baja mode, which is more of like a high speed off-road mode where the suspension goes about as soft as it can and gives you the most travel. And this is just hilarious what it's able to do on this road. You know, the divots just don't really make a difference when you're riding on 35 inch Goodyear all-terrain tires. You know, 35 inches just gives you so much space to do this stuff like this. Again, I think that maybe the Land Rover Defender and maybe the Jeep Gladiator Mojave were just a little bit softer on these, but I think that's the price that you pay for just the amazing performance that you're getting out of this truck. Because again, this will be much faster than both of those two vehicles, like no problem. You know, it also has, in addition to the launch control, it does have a jump mode. So if you do end up sending this somewhere off-road in the air, it will be able to land softly. Unlike a Raptor, they were known for snapping frames just a little bit. And while you're up in the air, the truck will actually sense that and it'll slow down the wheels so you're just not flying through. We've got a little puddle here. Oh yes, this truck is pretty much unstoppable. You can have so much fun with it. I think it's better at this kind of high speed off-roading stuff, but if you wanted to, it does have the rock crawling mode, it does have the low range, and it does have the locking rear diff if you wanted to do some slower speed stuff, but I don't think that's quite as fun. So you can just have stupid fun with this thing off-road. It will do four-wheel burnouts with ease. It's hilarious, but again, that practicality is still there. It'll tow 8,100 pounds, which is not too terrible. It's got 1,300 pounds of payload, which is not too terrible as well. Again, there are better trucks for towing and comfort and things like that. But if you really boil it down to what is the T-Rex for? Fun. There's no reason for a truck like this to exist, but Ram built it anyway because they knew it was hilarious. And really, if you're looking to spend anywhere from $70,000 to $90,000 on the high end for one of these, I almost would rather have this over like a sports car, like a Corvette or a Porsche, because you can't do this in a Corvette or a sports car, but you can still take this to the drag strip and have a lot of fun with it. You can stick your whole family in it and go camping. So there's just so much flexibility that you can do with a truck like this, and it does everything except fuel economy really, really well. It's a laugh riot, and I think this is the most insane pickup truck ever built. So that was the 2021 Ram 1500 TRX. I think this is the craziest truck that has ever been built. It is more fun than a Raptor. It's more expensive than a Raptor, but we'll have to see. The next generation Raptor is coming out, and they are going to be doing a V8 powered Raptor R variant. So let's see how that stacks up with the T-Rex when it comes out. Your pricing is gonna start just under $70,000, about 85 grand if you want the launch edition. There's only 702 of those, so you probably missed your opportunity on that already. If you want it decked out like the way we have the T-Rex, you're gonna be spending over 90 grand. And I think if you've got it, there's really no better way to have an amazing time off-road. We really hope you've enjoyed this review of the Ram 1500 T-Rex. If you want to check out other videos just like it, we have them over on our channel, including a video of the regular Ram 1500 that does more of a deep dive on the interior and why you'd want a Ram over, say, an F-150 or a Chevy Silverado. I'll see you next time.